I am watching TV. Okay, if you do identify, I am watching TV is a present continuous sentence. I is the subject, I am watching is the verb, and TV is the object. Okay, so in this sentence, what we are supposed to understand is the subject is doing some action. The subject is doing action. The subject might be any of the pronoun or noun. Okay, coming to pronouns, I, we, you, he, she, it, and they. These are the pronouns already we have learned. Okay, this vertical line we call singular, and the second vertical line we call it plural, and the horizontal lines, first one is first person, second line is second person, and third line is third person. So what is very critical in tenses as well as active and passive voice and direct and indirect speech? Third person singular. In this category, even name also falls. Name. If it is a name singular, suppose a boy, a student, that falls under third person singular. Or Ravi is also third person singular. Whereas names also can be plural. Suppose you take students, boys, girls, that falls under third person plural. So when these are used, automatically all the rules what we have learned in present tenses automatically applicable. Okay, so in this example, I am watching TV, we have used first person singular pronoun as the subject. I am watching. Watching is V4 verb is preceded by B form. What are the B forms? Am, is, are, was, were. Again, this is a table. So these are the varieties of B. So this can be used in present and this can be used in past, horizontal lines. This is for singular, this is for plural. So am is used only with the I subject. So that in the example, I am watching. Other than that, any singular subject, he is used. He is, she is, it is, student is, boy is, girl is, like that. If the subject is plural in present tense, are, boys are, students are, girls are, like that. When it comes to past tense, he takes another form, that is was. Here there are two options in present, but in past there is only one, that is was. Okay, I was, he was, she was, it was, Ravi was, Ramesh was, Kirti was, like that. And when it is past plural, was takes plural form were. Along with this, there are the core forms of the be, as be, being, and being. These are used. Being is used in passive voice perfect, and being is used in passive voice perfect continuous and irregular continuous, and be is used in simple future. That we automatically come across in the examples. If ever any doubts, you can clarify by asking me after you make a note. Okay, and meantime I go with all the tenses transforming into passive voice, certain guidelines, rules, regulations we discuss, and please make a note of all this, and at the end of the session you can clarify your doubts. So coming to this, it is identified as a present continuous sentence. I am watching TV. See here, I am watching what? TV. So there is an object. If you want to make any sentence from active voice to passive voice, a basic understanding, what is active voice? Active voice in the sense when the subject is active, in the sense subject is doing action, or what subject usually does. If we talk with that sense, that is called active voice. Then what is passive voice? Passive in the sense subject is not important and object oriented importance is given. So what is happened to TV? Okay, so that in passive voice we start with the object as the subject. Understand? So The first rule of this passive voice is subject takes object place. Vice versa, object takes subject place. Rule number one. So that we have to write as TV as the first word in the sentence. Okay, and obviously we have already discussed I, we, you, he, she, it, and they. These we called as subjective case of personal pronouns. Do you remember in our 7th class we discussed it for a long time? Okay, all varieties of pronouns: subjective case of personal pronouns, objective case of personal pronouns, possessive pronouns, reflexive pronouns, all that. So when when this I, an indicative of first person singular pronoun, is at the beginning, that is the subject. When we change the place of this subject to object's place, it should be transformed into objective case. Objective case of pronouns, I changes into me, we changes into us, you remains as it is you, he becomes him, and she becomes her or hers, and it remains it, and they become them. Okay, so this is objective case of when there is a place change, automatically we have to change the form of the pronoun. If it is a noun, no problem. For example, instead of I, if I put here Raghu, Raghu is watching. Raghu is watching TV. If it is the case, Raghu can be taken as it is at the end part of the sentence as an object. So there is no objective form for noun. Understand? So only for pronouns we have to replace these pronouns into objective case. Try to recollect what we have discussed earlier regarding objective case of pronouns. Okay, so as a rule, first one, subject takes the object's place, object takes subject's place. So it is inversely occupying their places. So TV is either object or subject, both are same because TV is a name, noun it is. Okay, so that we have written TV. Now I am taking this personal pronoun, first person singular personal pronoun, into object's place. As I changes into object, what happens? It changes into me. Okay, yes. Next, point number two. Relevant be form is to be used. Here we have to identify and keep in mind what is the tense of this. So it is identified present continuous. So what is present continuous rule? The verb should be before, and relevant be form is supposed to be assisting the subject of the sentence. So in our passive voice, what is the subject? TV. TV, what person it is? It is not I, it is not first person, it's not second person, it comes under third person, under the category he, she, it, like that. So it is singular. So third person singular is to be associated with present be form is. Singular present be form is. Okay, so this is second rule. Okay, and the verb is in continuity. Continuity. The third rule is verb always in the passive voice should be V3. V3. V3 in the sense, if we observe here the verb watch, watch, watched, watched. Now you need to understand how important we are about to learn all the three forms, or at least four forms of the verbs. You have made a list. Every day you have written some 5 verbs. Okay, so watch, watched, watched. So we write here watched. W-A-T-C-H-E-D is the V three form of the verb. Then if it is a continuous tense, there should be an ing form. Without ing form, we cannot say this is continuity. So that ing form we add in the form of be, another form, being. TV is being watched. Okay, and next, verb must be followed by preposition by. Preposition by. Okay, so what happened here? As a part of first rule, there are two things. Subject takes object's place, so that TV is put at the beginning. Object takes subject's place, and accordingly, I is taken into objective form. Two things completed, and relevant be form is used to indicate the tense. To indicate the tense. So, as it is present tense, we use is, and verb must be always V3. Verb must be always V3, and that is put here, that relevant V3, and to indicate the exact tense. So, continuity of the tense is identified with be form, and preposition is used here to indicate that is done by something. Okay, so there are very clearly 5 different steps to follow it. When you transform an active sentence into passive sentence, automatically that is to be verified, just like in mathematics. If you solve the problem, when you get some answer, from the answer side, if you reconstruct that, you automatically need to get the question. Likewise, here also, step 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5. So, whether all the 5 steps are followed or not, when we verify it, automatically we get active into passive sentence. So, ultimately, what is the purpose of this passive sentence? We give focus to the object of a active sentence and talk in that version. What happened to TV? Got it? So, these are the 5 varieties of steps that are to be followed in transforming one sentence from active to passive voice. Okay. Then, can all the sentences be changed into passive voice? No. All sentences, all tenses cannot be changed into passive voice. For example, it is not only the tenses, even few other things are there which cannot be. Because if ever we write some sentence in passive voice, that should have a sense. Senseless sentences we need not transform. For example, you write, I go to school. In this sentence, I go, simple present it is, to school. It is not going to be a direct object of I. What happened to school? Nothing happened. So that if you write it, school is gone by me. What sense we like to convey in this? There is no sense at all. So that when the object is not a direct object, or else when there is no object at all, we cannot, of course we can, but it is senseless. For example, birds fly. There is no object here. Birds subject fly well. Okay, birds fly, there is no object, there is no targeted action, there is no target for the action. When there is no target, it is highly senseless and impossible to make it. Okay, such kind of sentences cannot be transformed into that passive voice. And according to tenses, all the perfect continuous tenses, perfect continuous. All the perfect continuous in the sense present, past and future. All the three. Present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous and future perfect continuous. All these three sentences in active voice, they cannot be transformed into passive voice. Okay. And one more. Future continuous. Okay. Future continuous. So as a whole, we talked of total 12 tenses are there. Out of these 12, perfect continuous are 3 and future continuous is 1. Total 4 tenses cannot be transformed into passive voice. In the sense, in passive voice, we will have only the remaining 8 tenses only. What are they? Present simple, present continuous, present perfect. And again, past simple, past continuous, past perfect. And future simple, a future perfect. Only 8. So, each variety of tense, now we transform for your better understanding. Hope you grasped it. There are 5 steps to be followed and we need to have some stock knowledge in our mind. What are the different verbs? What are the forms of verbs? Forms of verbs. Present form, past form and what do you say? Third one. Past perfect. Okay? Yes. V1, V2, V3 and V4. All these 4 versions we need to have. Okay. Now I transform present sentences. Present sentences. I start with the simple. Let us see. Students learn grammar. Very simple sentence. Students learn grammar. Students subject, learn V1, grammar object. Subject V1, object. It is an active voice. What students are doing? Students are the subject. They are doing something. So that it is that one. Simple present. Now, step 1. Object should come in the subject's place. Let grammar come at the beginning. One important thing. As a continuation of sentences, grammar I have put small letter G. But where we are bringing that grammar at the beginning of the sentence, so the beginning of the sentence is always must be capital letter. Okay. Grammar. Okay, for convenience, we will make stepwise now. And subject should go to the object's place. Students. Students is a noun and it is in plural. So that I am not changing any of the objective case, subjective case like that. Only in the case of pronouns, we have to change objective cases. So, grammar has become subject, students, object. And step 2, relevant be form. Relevant be form. What tense it is? It is present tense. In present tense, what are the be forms? Am, is, are. Okay. Grammar. Is the grammar singular or plural? Grammar is one. So, it is singular. And there are 2 options. Am, is. What is to be used out of these 2 options? Am. It is identical, am is used only with I. So our subject is not I. So that other option is. So this is indicating, yes, this is present tense. Okay? Yes. Next, step 2 completed. Sorry, step 3 completed. Now what next? Always the verb must be in the V3 form. What is V3 for this learn? Learned. V1, V2, V3 and learning V4. Okay. So learned. So we take this learned. Step 4, V3 form. Okay. Next, what is the last one? Verb must be followed by a preposition. What preposition it is? Always by. When it is something is done by some agent, automatically we use a pronoun by. Okay. So that step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5. Okay. So subject, object inversely change their places, and this is the be form, and this is the V3, and this is the preposition. So all the 5 steps completed. Now students learn grammar has become into grammar is learned by students. Okay, this is a simple present tense being changed into passive voice. Now I take present continuous. I take the pronoun for the example. We are playing tennis. We are playing tennis. We subject, are be form, playing be form, and tennis object. Subject plus be form plus be form plus object, present continuous in active voice. Okay, so how to change it? Step 1, tennis should come at the beginning. Object into the subject's place and subject in object's place. What is our subject? We. We is a pronoun. So it is subjective case of pronoun. We are using at the beginning of the sentence. And so this pronoun we are taking at the end part of the sentence, that is objective place. So when it becomes objective, it becomes us. Okay. Yeah. Step 1, step 2 completed. Next, to indicate the tense, what is the be form? Again, am, is, are, because we are dealing with only the present tense. So what is to be used? Tennis, third person singular. So that is. Tennis is. And verb always should be V3. Play, V3. Play, played, played. So, played. And how do we indicate the continuity of action? Continuity of action in the ing form. There is no availability of verb in ing form. So that additional supplement is with be. We are using ing form. Being. Okay. So being played. And verb must be followed by a preposition. Now it became tennis is being played by us. It is the passive voice of present continuous. Okay. Next, present perfect. They have completed worksheet. Active voice. They have completed worksheet. Let us bifurcate and understand. They subject, worksheet object, have, perfect indicative, completed V3. See here, even in active voice there is V3. What happens if it is changed into passive voice? Nothing. V3 remains the same. So they, third person plural, subject. It is a pronoun. Third person plural, subject. Have is a perfect indicative as it is plural. Completed, V3. And worksheet object. Subject plus have or has plus V3 plus object. Present perfect structure. It is an active voice. Then how to transform that? Worksheet we bring forth. Worksheet. Is it singular or plural? Singular. What person it is? Third person. Because it's a name. third person singular noun it is. Okay, we brought the object at the beginning, and let us take this subject into objects place. They, when they is changed into objective place, what happens? Them. Okay, next. So it is perfect. What is the perfect indicative? Perfect indicative. As it is plural, we have used we have, and worksheet is not plural. So here we need to be very careful. Here the subject is plural, so that it is have. But in passive voice, subject is singular, so it is has. Worksheet, third person singular. Third person singular is always associated with has. Worksheet has. Okay, and verb remains V3 as it is. Then how do we indicate the be form for perfect? Be form for perfect is be. Okay, and verb followed by a preposition. Worksheet subject, them object, has perfect indicative, been be form, completed V3 by preposition. So all the five steps: subject place change, object place change, perfect indicative, and be form, and V3 form of the passive voice of verb, and followed by the preposition by. Okay, so this is the way all the present tenses we can make into passive voice. And we need to be very careful when the subject and the object are in different numbers. See here, they is plural, worksheet is singular, and the singular has come at the beginning, in the sense subject's place. So the relevant indicators must be there, either it is perfect indicative or be form or anything. Okay, so we need to be very cautious in transforming subject and object related to be forms. Okay, so this is the way we can change present tenses into passive voice. Got it? Now we take the examples of past tense. In the second instant, we try to know how we change passive active sentences, past active sentences into passive voice. So now I am dealing with past tense. Past tense, active passive transformation. Let us take one past action. She drew a picture. Draw, drew, draw. She drew a picture. She, subject, drew, V2, a picture, object. This is in active voice. She is the subject. What she does or what she did in this sentence, that is mentioned there. She drew, subject V2. Subject V2 is always simple past. So what she drew a picture, so there is a direct object. Okay, so picture is getting affected by her, so that it is complete active sentence. Then when we take it into passive construction, picture comes at the beginning, a capital. As a whole, it is a picture is the object. Don't separate that. A picture. A picture is our subject here. And she, third person singular, it is in subjective case. So we have to take that she into objective position. So she, when it is taken at the end of the sentence, becomes her. Her. Okay, next, what tense it is? It is a simple past. What is the simple past be form? was, were. Picture is singular. So what is singular here? Was singular and were plural. So we have to make use of was as the be form. A picture was. Next, V2 is drew. What is V3? Draw, drew, drawn. Drawn, V3. And followed by preposition. So subject, object, be form, V3, and preposition. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First steps. So picture has come to the beginning of the sentence. In the sense, subject's place. She is taken to the object's place. And according to tense, we use the be form. And according to the rule, we have changed that verb into V3 form and object, verb followed by preposition. So it became a picture was drawn by her. This is the transformation into passive voice. Okay, that is past simple. Coming to past continuous. Past continuous. He was doing homework. He was doing homework. He, subject, was, past be form, doing, V4, homework, object. Subject plus was plus V4 plus object. Past continuous. Okay? So, this past continuous, how it is to be? It is quite easy because he is singular, homework is also singular. Okay? Now, we bring that homework at the beginning. In the sense, subject's place. And he is going to the end part. When it is going to the object's place, becomes him. Okay? So, two things done. And what is the indicative of be? So, homework is the person singular, so that remains the same. Third person singular it is. He is also third person singular. So that there is no change in the be form indicating the past. Okay? And according to passive rule, verb must be always V3. What is the V3 of do? Do, did, done. Do, did, done. V1, V2, V3. So this doing is to be changed into done. Okay, we changed it. But continuity can be indicated so that we take the assistance of be form here. Being an indicative of continuity. And done, V3. And followed by preposition. Then becomes passive voice. Let us see. Homework has become subject. Him, object, was being is the be form indicative of past continuity. And verb, V3, and by preposition. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First steps completed. So he was doing homework is transformed into homework was being done by him is the passive construction. And coming to past perfect. Past perfect. We had drunk milk. Probably you have done it. So I am telling this. Exactly you have completed right after you wake up. We had drunk milk. We, subject, milk, object, had, perfect indicative in past, drunk V3. In perfect automatically verb is V3 in active. So it is the active voice. Past perfect. So OA plural, milk singular. Understand? OA is first person plural, milk is third person singular. So in past there is no matter of first person, second person. So don't worry about it. Now we bring that object into subject's place. Milk is brought at the beginning. We going to the end part. In the sense, object part. So we, when it is gone, end part, it becomes us. Okay? So two things are done. Subject and object are changed. And what is the tense? Perfect. Past perfect. So there is no other option. So had, had, and be form. In passive voice, perfect indicative be form is been, and V3 is already there. So we put V3 as it is, and verb must be followed by a preposition. So subject, object, be form as a whole, and V3 and preposition. So we had drunk milk is changed into milk had been drunk by us. Okay, this is the way in perfect, past perfect, we can change active sentence into passive sentence. Okay, now let us come to the last tense, that is future tense. In future already we discussed two tenses may not be transformed into passive. What are they? Future continuous and future perfect continuous. So what are remaining? Remaining are only two. Future simple and future perfect. Let us see how to transform this future tense active sentences. Okay, next. Gopal will eat a banana probably after lunch. Gopal will be doing that. That is our expectation. It is all. Future is purely an expectation. There is no guarantee, warranty for that, whether it is happens or not. Gopal will eat a banana. It is an active voice sentence. Let us see how it is. Gopal subject, will future indicative, and eat V1, and banana, a banana object. Okay, subject plus will or shall plus V1 plus object. Simple future. Now let us take this. Gopal is singular, banana is also singular, and both are in noun form, not in the pronoun form. Both are in noun form. So there is no confusion of changing that into some other thing. So we bring that object, a banana, into subject space. Let us take Gopal to the object space. Gopal, proper noun. So proper noun must be always to be started with a capital letter. So that I have written G capital. So A banana, Gopal. Subject, object replaced. Next, it is a future. Future is by default we need to put future indicative. Okay, so that I use will. Okay, then it is simple. And what be form is to be used here? There is no future be form we discuss. What are left? Be, been, being. Okay, being we are using it continuous as be form, and being we used in perfect. Okay, so what is left? Be. Okay, this is the be form, and verb should take V3. What is V3 for eat? Eat, ate, eaten. V1, V2, V3. Eat, eaten, and eating. Okay? So, eaten, V3, and followed by preposition by. So now it became the subject is banana, object is Gopal, and will by default we use it future indicative so that we don't consider that, and be form and eaten, be three, and preposition by. Gopal will eat a banana has been transformed into a banana will be eaten by Gopal. Will be eaten by Gopal. Okay, this is future simple. Now coming to future perfect. Students will have completed. Students will have completed worksheets. So all the time factors we are not mentioning for simple understanding. Students will have completed. Let us say students is subject. Now in plural form. Noun in plural form. Okay. So will future indicative, have perfect indicative, and completed V3, and worksheet is an object. Okay. So subject plus will plus have V3 plus object. Future perfect it is. So what is the object in this active sentence? Worksheet. Worksheet is singular. So we brought worksheet here. And we take students other side. Students is not a proper noun. Common noun it is. So that is S small letter. So worksheet is brought to the subject. And students is brought to object. And as it is a future tense, we use will. Okay. And what is perfect indicative here? In future, perfect indicative, no option. Only have. Only have. Okay. So, and in passive voice, what is to be associated the be form in perfect? Be. And what is the verb form here? Be3. Even in passive voice also? Same. And followed by preposition. So let us see. Perfect indicative, be form, V3, preposition, object. So worksheet will have been completed by students. This is the passive structure of future perfect tense. Understand? What is the active? Students will have completed worksheet. That became worksheet will have been completed by students.